This time of year, it's possible to see some pretty scary sights. In a few days, Halloween will be upon us, bringing all manner of goblins and ghosts. In keeping with the theme of our 40th anniversary, and for all of our newer employees, here's a retelling of stories of actual hauntings at Columbus State. This story was filed by our own underworld correspondent, Dr. Frank Alucard, of the Unnatural Sciences Department.
Good evening. Have you ever wondered about this small marker located on the mallway just outside of Nestor Auditorium? It reads, Rest in Peace. Well, over the years, Columbus State has been the scene of many strange and unexplained incidents, some of them paranormal. Fleeting glimpses of an apparition. A tall woman accompanied by a small child have been reported by a number of late-night campus police and custodial workers. Numerous unexplained incidents have been reported in the library, the auditorium, and the darkened passageways of Nestor Hall. The Columbus Dispatch and the other paper have run articles on the hauntings here at Columbus State. So yes, it must be true. There are more things in heaven and earth than mere mortals can imagine.
The ERC has been the source of many of the campus ghost stories. Sometimes we've heard strange voices or noises, even in the daytime. It sounds like a whole group of people talking. But when we've looked for the source, there's absolutely no one around. Other things, like doors slamming and books flying off the shelves. The elevator often takes off by itself. Nothing really malicious, more like pranks. I mean, who are you gonna call?
Who are you gonna call?
Back when I first started here, about 15 years ago, we used to be responsible for locking up the Columbus Hall. So one night, I was coming over here after the library closed, and it had been about 9:39, been dark out, and I noticed the lights on the second floor. So I went through each floor and just checking the building to make sure everything was okay. I got to the second floor, checked the building out, nobody was in there. I turned all the lights off and went back downstairs to start locking the doors. Well, while I was on the first floor, I started getting a real eerie cold chill through me. I didn't know what it was at first, so I just kind of ignored it. It happened again. And then all of a sudden, I started hearing voices of children getting upstairs. And I thought, I just checked that. And I got my curiosity going. So I started listening real close, and it sounded like a bunch of children playing, and adult and women, like with their children, all playing like a game. So I went up the back steps to go check it, and there was nobody there.
But why here? The answer may be found in the earliest records of the property. In the years prior to the Civil War, the entire Catholic population of Columbus attended tiny St. Remigius Church, an unnamed cemetery, simply called Catholic Cemetery, occupied 3 acres of property on the corners of Mount Vernon and Washington Avenues. By 1868, the cemetery had long been filled and fallen into disrepair. It is estimated that over 4,000 bodies were buried here, on the very spot that Columbus State is built upon. I tell my students that the spirit world is nothing to be afraid of. They're okay. Maybe a little angry. They're just lost souls looking to make up incomplete assignments in the material world and looking for daytime parking spaces. Anyway, if you'd like to learn more about the hauntings at Columbus State, there's an excellent article on the entire legend written by Suzanne May with Institutional Advancement. You can find it on the in-service website. Meanwhile, trick or treat, you decide. Back to you, Steve.